Hey, welcome back to Dark Cloud 2. I am back in a level I've already done because I have to go down the sun door path. And you motherfucker, you hid behind a fucking rock. I do really enjoy this poison effect. A constant 340 damage. It may be a slow burn, but... Oh, do I have to get the last hit? Shit. That was real quick to find the sun door. Now I just gotta get the battery. I don't really plan on killing everybody in this damn place. If I can get the battery, I can get the fuck out of here. I don't want to spend any more time on a floor I've already been on than I have to. Well, that wasn't that hard. It didn't take that long. And this one has a fucking white seal on it. I hate that shit. This one doesn't have a seal on it, but this one fucking does. That means it's probably gonna have poison and shit. And okay, Tiamat. So there's dragons here. That's fantastic, because they put status ailments on me, I think. You know, it's been a while since I fought any dragons, so maybe that's not true. Oh, they got robots here too, so they got big enemies. Now, I'm kind of cool with that, because it's the status ailments that fucking suck. Because I heal myself the whole damn time I'm fighting. I don't really need... to deal with like healing myself. No, not worth it. Normally I just pick exploding chests so that whatever's in the chest doesn't get destroyed and then I can deal with, okay, King Mimic, fuck you. You do have status ailments. You ain't that strong though. This series is getting pretty close to being done. Minotaurus. The series is basically right here at the end. It'll probably be done this month. And I don't know what exactly the plan is right now. Because, like, we got the list. We got shit that's on the list that's been on there for a long damn time. We have to go through and figure out, all right, what do I own and what kind of thing can I actually do and all of that shit. Hi, you stupid fuck. So, I have the thought in my head of, like, what's going to replace this? And it's such a long-running series at this point. Like, I don't know if I want to replace it with something that's short, quick, easy, that sort of thing. Or if it's something that I want to replace with, like, another thing that's probably long-running. Because that was weird. That was the thing about Elden Ring. I wasn't expecting Elden Ring to be... Okay, I tried to hit block and then I fucked that up. That's great. Yeah, I fucking knew that was gonna happen. I just figured I would do that. So I guess I'll reload, come back to this floor. That motherfucker's tough. That white seal does not fucking matter. If I get one shot. Oh, come on. God damn it. Okay, so I have very little health, and that is because I saved inside of the mines, and then I left the mine to go outside and heal, and then come back in. And I didn't fucking leave and come back in this time because I thought I'd saved after that. So that fucking sucks. So I was trying to say, and maybe I won't die while I'm trying to say it this time. Oh, there's a fucking healing thing on a white seal room? That's weird. Isn't it? I don't think I've ever seen that. So Elden Ring was something I was expecting to be more like Dark Souls, a clear through line of where you're supposed to go and what you're supposed to do. Very linear RPG. And I knew that it was open world because I'd seen stuff about it. I didn't start playing it for like a year after it came out, something like that. But I wasn't expecting it to be what it ended up being. So because it's so open and because there's so much to be done, I'm playing it like I would any other like big open world RPG, which means that I'm going to take forever to play it because I'm interested in what's going on, even if I'm not doing a great job of keeping up with the story that I have been trying to keep up with. I am failing to keep up with that storyline. But I thought of that as being a much shorter series than it has become. And the same sort of thing with this. I didn't think this was going to be as long of a series as it has become. But I knew nothing about this one. This one is an extremely linear RPG. And I got through quite a few levels in almost every episode. I got through quite a few levels. Getting through as much as I have in like a singular episode doesn't mean a whole lot when there's a whole lot of game to get through. So I was thinking about it as like, is this something that... All right, you're a different color altogether. That's fantastic. I was thinking about it as maybe replacing this with something that's like as long of a series is necessary. Or maybe replacing it with something that's a much quicker thing is a good idea. How much is that going to do? That did a bit. Knocked you down. That did more than this fucking thing's doing. If I can kind of point at you, I can shoot. It doesn't do a whole lot of damage. But you don't have the range to hit me as long as I'm not actually in range. If I just back off and fucking... Oh, shit! No, that actually fucking followed me all the way there. God damn, man. You shouldn't be allowed to do that. Damn it. I don't think I can actually progress with Monica here, and I don't have, like, the resurrection powder. See, I'm full up on escape powders, so I don't have a problem with doing that. That's the toughest one I've been in. That's actually pretty fucking difficult. I've been going for a long while at this point, and I still hadn't gotten that one done. I guess I do need to try... I have to beat it, so I have to try it again, at the very least. I can't cure or heal. Well, having that healing thing was pretty fucking nice. I don't guess I'm going to get that opportunity again, am I? I guess, like, this did a whole lot. Throwing bombs at the motherfucker worked. I need something that does, like, explosive damage. I got a bunch of bombs. That one's just the only real powerful one. The rest of these, they don't do that much. And you got like a long fucking range. I see that fucking hitbox. It was going through the damn wall. Guy's got a long range fucking attack. And it goes through a damn wall. Alright. I can block it fully though. So I just need to actually fucking fully block it. When I see him going for it, I need to just... hole up. That's a bitch, man. Plus, Bone King makes me think of, like, the skeleton enemies. And the skeleton enemies had, like, that fall down and then get back up. Yep, that fucking thing. Alright, here, take this shit. That'll knock your ass down a little bit. Oh, you get the spam on you that way. That guy's a dick, man. He needs explosive damage. Well, this thing does full explosive damage. This gun is insane. And yet it's not doing enough there. There's got to be at least a few of those motherfuckers on this floor. Because that last one, I saw a couple of them. I was saying before that I felt like I could get through like three of these per episode, but I have already been playing for so damn long that it feels like that's not gonna happen today. If that Bone King doesn't show up in any future levels, if it's just this one, then it won't be so bad later down the road, but it still fucking sucks now. Okay. God damn it. These guys are easy. That fucking sucks. It kind of feels like you're not supposed to fucking play this game in a way that levels up both of your character's defense and shit. It feels a bit to me like what I'm supposed to do is level up one of their defenses. Like I should have concentrated on Max or Monica, and that was what I was supposed to do. You have learned how to use Magic Absorb Blade? It's a skill that allows you to absorb the energy of elemental attacks such as fire while guarding. When you swing your sword, it fires back as magic. Charge up energy. What the fuck? How is this something that you're teaching me here in the end of the game? I have learned to use elemental absorb on my sword. That's fucking weird, man. You know what? Fuck this. I can't heal or anything. I'm gonna look around real quick. See if there's any way for me to get... Like, there's the cart. Yep. I'm getting the hell out of here. I'm gonna try one more mission. I got out of there. It does feel like anytime I face a difficulty that Maxie can't handle, I just don't let Monica handle the next one because I hadn't trained her up. But that sword having a special power is kind of useless to me because she's got to be better. And like I said, it feels like there's a certain like defense that I was supposed to get that I just hadn't gotten. I wonder if I was supposed to only be boosting one of their defenses and that was it. They called this one Ultimate Snake. And I don't like that fucking snake enemy, so this is probably gonna fucking suck as well. For different reasons, perhaps. That snake is not that big a deal to defeat most of the damn time. Oh, and I broke my damn gun immediately, didn't I? Yeah, that wasn't that hard to fight. As long as I am looking at the motherfucker, it ain't a big deal. God damn it. I was blocking that shit and it didn't block the whole fucking damage. Son of a bitch. Alright, well, I feel like I'm learning. Feel like I'm learning shit that I probably wouldn't need most of the damn time. You didn't even get the chance to go underground that time, motherfucker. I don't know how many times I'm gonna fight this fucking cannon enemy. Alright, you're easy to kill, right? I hadn't had any problems with your kind before. You're easy enough as well. As long as I don't get fucking petrified. God damn, man, but they are strong. I think I talked about it before that was like, they do a shitload of damage, and I'm guessing that the reason they do a shitload of damage is kind of like to encourage you to use your healing items and stuff. But it doesn't encourage me to use my healing items if I'm getting one shot. If I get hit one fucking time, don't... Okay. Come on. I hit you and you didn't dodge it. It just went right through you. I guess it makes sense for a Wraith. Can't be something I'm upset about when it's obvious that a ghost isn't going to get hit by bullets 100% of the time. I'm going to see if Ride Pod fucking means anything here. Because, like, I'm not doing more damage with Ride Pod than I am with Maxie. But I can move faster. I have a longer lock-on range. Or maybe I don't. Also, it's always frustrating that lock-on doesn't actually mean that the camera looks at the motherfucker. Because that's kind of the most useful thing about it is that the camera looks directly at somebody when you're locked on to them in a game. So that kind of sucks. This one method takes so fucking long. Like, I'm not doing shit to this. It's like 150 is the max damage no matter how far or how close I am. I don't hit 100% of the time. It's not enough damage because these enemies clearly have several thousand HP. I don't think that running around with Ride Pod is the best idea here because I'm not really doing enough with this and I'm running out of durability on these really quick. I was thinking about, you know, I don't really need more metals. I'm just trying to get through the damn thing. Yeah, fuck it. I got the battery. I don't need the metals. I'm just gonna leave. Like, I'm not really leveling Max's gun up enough to do anything because nothing's actually changing here. It's exactly the same from one floor to the next. And I've been going for so goddamn long at this point that I beat two levels today and neither of them did I actually beat. I didn't get through killing all the enemies and doing that. I didn't clear the floor. This shit is still there. So, yeah, I'm done for the day, but it doesn't feel like I actually got anything done. I made progress, but only in the most literal sense. I hope you enjoyed it anyway. I hope you come back for the next one. I'll see y'all later. Bye.